I guess what I'm trying to do more recently is do the basic stuff, like if you were a beginner. I can't stand when people talk like you already know what it is. Like, oh yeah, you're going to take the PC35 valve connected to the coax discombobulator. And that's how you get this. What? So I'm going to make it simple. Why you do things and how you do them, etc. So sometimes I make it a little detailed. That's because I want you to know the details. I had an ick outbreak. Oh, well, Steve's always talking about quarantining, and oh, he's always talking about preventing ick. And I know there's a lot of haters out there right about now that are saying, yeah, I knew it. Once you have ick in your tank, you'll always have ick in your tank. You never get rid of it. Bullshit. I got rid of it. My tank was thriving for a year and a half. And I always quarantine brand new fish for 4 weeks before I put them in my main tank. I quarantine them with copper. Alright, so you know how it happened? I bought a damn anemone. I had a bad feeling about it.
I have a very bad feeling about this.
I got a bad feeling about this.
I have a bad feeling about this.
But I have a bad feeling about this.
I have a really bad feeling about this.
I did take some clean salt water and dip the anemone in it. I dipped it in a separate container and then in a third container before putting it in my display tank. Apparently that wasn't enough. What I should have done, and I thought about doing this, but I didn't read anywhere where people were doing this, but I should have taken like a cheap Rubbermaid container, like a 2 gallon, filled it with regular salt water, and just put the anemone in it and a cheap little tiny heater just to keep it 78 degrees, no fish, nothing, just leave it in there for 4 weeks or 5 weeks. And you can't quarantine it in copper. Quarantine everything. I quarantine all fish. I use dead rock. I use dead sand. I make my own water at home. And I saw my blue tang has speckles on it, like she was dosed with salt flakes, salt crystals on her body. Minor, but they were there. I thought, oh man, are you kidding me? Because a fish's body is supposed to be smooth and completely sheen, like wet rubber, you know, just slick. Well, she had some salt crystals on her. Like, son of a bitch, are you kidding me? So, I also noticed her flash against the rock. Flashing is when a fish goes to a rock and just quickly zooms like that and twists its body to try and itch itself. It's trying to get the parasites out of the body. Great. So that was the blue tang Dory, named a Dory, and took her out, fished her out, threw her in the quarantine tank with copper. And some people say if you can get them out of the tank before the parasites fall off their body and fall to the sand and multiply, there's a chance that no one else will have it. I didn't want to take that chance. So I took them all out. There was a weak link, and that was introducing two things, the anemone, and I bought a few turbo snails. I just took those guys and put them in fresh salt water, dip once, let them roam around there for a few minutes, then I put them in my tank. Apparently that wasn't good enough. Today, I came home to my yellow tang who passed away, my blue tang Dory, my yellow tang who was with me since the beginning, my 28 gallon tank. I have my fowlery tang left, thank God, my prize display fish. I have my coal tang, I have my 2 clowns, I have a yellow watchman goby and a sand sifter. That's it. So I'm going to be purchasing a blue tang again and another yellow tang. Copper in the 75 gallon for 2 weeks. The last 4 weeks are going to be salt water only, no copper. Canister filter underneath. Pretty easy to set up. Really nice unit. I've never had a canister filter before, but I got to tell you, I really, really like it. I'll open that up and I'll clean it once a week to get all the rotten food and all the fish crap and everything that it captures out of there. I've got a makeshift light. I was going to put my LED strip on top of it from my display tank, but my corals need the light. Water coming out, as you can see here, is breaking up nicely, and there's a lot of bubbles getting into that tank, which helps to oxygenate that water. I know I've done a handful of videos on ick, but that's because it's really important. And I still get the questions, well, what if you feed them garlic? No, it won't work. Or, well, my fish had ick before, and then they clear it up. It doesn't matter, it's in your tank, they're gonna get it again. You cannot cure ick, it's a flesh-eating parasite. It's got teeth, it's microscopic. It embeds itself in the fish, it finds a host to eat alive. It eats your fish from the inside out. You can't get used to that. That's like me saying, oh, you're going on safari? Lions? I hope you ate your Wheaties. Oh, make sure you take an extra dose of vitamin C. Not just two, take 3-4 vitamin C pills just to be safe. Because you want to get your immunity up to protect yourself against those lions, okay? I had this guy who's a biologist, he said he's a doctor, he left a bunch of comments basically slamming me. He says I need to get my head out of the clouds and stop thinking with my imagination. Jackass. He's telling me that the fish will get immune to it. And I asked him, how are your damn fish going to build up an immunity to a host situation where the fish have teeth and they're microscopic and they're eating your fish from the inside out? How the hell are your fish going to build up an immunity to that? No answer. So, I messed up by not quarantining the anemone. Should have never got the damn thing. If you're going to get a coral, use the Coral X to dip your coral to get free of the little pests that might be on it. But it won't get rid of the ick or marine velvet. For that, I would just say put it in a Rubbermaid container and just let it sit there for 4 to 5 weeks. You know, maybe change out the water once a week. All right? I want to say thank you to my subscribers. Without you guys, I wouldn't be doing this. Your comments keep me going. To be honest, there's some times where I think, should I do this? Should I keep going with the weekly show? But I get subscribers, I get more and more, and I got some really nice comments this week saying, this show is really funny, I've learned a lot, it's very educational and entertaining. That is so cool. That is payment in and of itself. So thank you so much for those comments, you guys. I love reading them. I check through the comments every day. I respond to them all. Unlike a lot of those jackass YouTube shows, you leave a comment and they just never, you know, read it or respond. What the hell is that? Again, that's bullshit is what that is. Pisses me off. Pardon my Italian, but I hate that. You make videos, you want to teach people, and you want to do things, and then they comment, you just ignore it? What the hell is that? It's bullshit is what that is. So anyway, I'm going to keep you posted on this. Thank you all. See you next weekend. Subscribe. Make the channel bigger so we can reach more reefers and we can help more people. Alright? Take care.